Are you a digital nomad working from the road? Or maybe you're just looking for a reliable internet connection when you're out there, whenever you can, enjoying the RV lifestyle? Well, stay tuned, because in this video roundup, I'm going to show you the latest tools in cell phone and Wi-Fi boosters aimed at the RV market. I didn't even know that I was the trendsetter. For almost 7 years now, I have been working location independent out of my RV all across North America. Well, it turns out there's a name for people like me, digital nomads. Some are part-time, taking off when the mood hits them. Others have shucked corporate jobs, given up sticks and bricks homes, and now full-time in their RV, earning their living as they travel the country. They're able to work remotely, of course, because of the internet. And one way to do that is through Wi-Fi. But another way that most digital nomads use to get that solid internet connection they need is through this, a MiFi or a Jetpack card that creates a wireless mobile hotspot using the cellular network to connect to the internet. Now, most cell phones also can create a hotspot, and that may be enough for many RVers, but those who depend on the internet, note that using your smartphone's hotspot for today's 4G networks wears down the phone battery something fierce. Now, that takes us to the tools that we want to concentrate on in this video, the Wi-Fi and the cellular boosters that are available. The biggest factor in not getting a cellular internet connection is because of a weak signal, which is usually caused because you're too far from the cell phone tower. Cell boosters have an outside antenna that finds whatever signal there is and connects to an amplifier, which then boosts those signals up to 32 times, and then uses an indoor antenna to rebroadcast the enhanced signal. It used to be that only one company really controlled this market, Wilson Amplifiers, makers of the popular WeBoost brand. Now, several other companies have jumped into the fray. Wilson, to be sure, is still the big 500-pound gorilla in the market, but there's some competition. But let's start off by talking about WeBoost. Their amplifiers range in price from about $200 all the way up to nearly $700. For smartphone users, the $199 Drive Sleek may be enough. It is aimed at your cell phone. The cell fits in the cradle, which also has the amplifier. A small magnetic mount antenna goes outside on the roof, and you usually snake the wire in through a door or window. This is aimed more at the automobile market, but it does serve as an affordable step up from no booster at all for RVers who don't need to tax the internet that much. This is WeBoost's $689 top-of-the-line model, the Connect RV65 cell phone signal booster kit. It comes in a mighty big box. The amplifier, outside and inside antennas come in one part, but the rest of the box holds a mast. This mast telescopes to 25 feet. Now, this product is aimed at RVers who are not moving. They're parked in one spot. You put the directional antenna at the top of the mast, secure it against your RV with a mounting kit, and then point it towards the nearest cell tower. How do you know where that cell tower is? Through an app. There are several available, and I'll put links to them in the description below. For Jennifer and me, this is not really a viable solution. This kind of a setup is really best with a fifth wheel or a Class A. One, because they tend to sit in one place long enough, and it's a lot of work putting that antenna up, fastening it, and then taking it down. But another reason it's best for large rigs is because the antennas and the booster need to be a certain distance apart. Those of us who are digital nomads in camper vans and Class Bs, we need a better solution. I've had great success with the WeBoost Drive 4GM. It sells for $379. It has a 12-volt power supply that connects to a cigarette lighter. It has indoor and outdoor antennas. And this is the unit that I had on our previous RV. It did a great job. We ran a test, in fact, and here are the results. We just ran a speed test, and without the booster, it takes 31 milliseconds for a ping. The download speed is 3.65, and the upload speed is barely moving 0.44. That is with one bar, and that is without the booster. Now with the booster in line, we're going to check it, and we can see a pretty fast improvement in the ping. And now we're checking the download speed. The download speed, I can tell you, is a tremendous improvement. Look at that. We are already at 22.15 Mbps, and now we're checking the upload speed to see what that does. And the upload speed is also showing a big improvement, reading out at 6.79. So that is a dramatic improvement when we put in the booster. So on our new RV, what cell phone booster am I going to install? Well, I've got a choice now. Remember a little while ago I said that WeBoost was no longer the only real player in town? Well, I have units from two other companies now that I'm considering. The first is from a company called Solid RF. It's a Canadian company, and they make this. This is the Mobile Force 4G. It sells for $299. That's about $80 less than the comparable unit offered by WeBoost. Here's what it looks like. So what's in the box? Well, the amplifier itself is similar in size and shape to what you see with WeBoost. It has four lights that indicate what band that it is receiving on the cell phone. It's got mounting holes here so you can mount it on a wall or in the back of a cabinet. Connection for the outside antenna, a connection for the inside antenna. Here's the inside antenna. It has some stick-on tape, so you could put that up at the top of a wall to give you coverage throughout the RV. This is the outside antenna, just a little, tiny little magnetic mount right there. You run the wire inside, and there is a DC cigarette-type plug adapter here for power for the unit. The same company also makes a more powerful unit called the Mobile Force 4G. This, though, is probably more aimed at motorhomes that are at least the size of a Class C or larger, also a fifth wheel or a Class A, of course. Now, the reason why this wouldn't necessarily work on a camper van is because of that separation factor needed between the two antennas and the amplifier itself. There's not enough room in a Class B for that. This model costs $399. It is about $100 cheaper than the similar unit offered by WeBoost. Here is something aimed squarely at digital nomads that I think you're going to be hearing a whole lot about. This is called the Connect 2. It is from WineGuard. That's a familiar name to RVers. WineGuard's been making RV TV antennas for a long time. Now they are solidly in the cell phone and the Wi-Fi booster arena. This unit, the Connect 2, sells for about $360, but here is what is most interesting about this. Not only is this a powerful cell phone booster, but it also amplifies any Wi-Fi signals in the area. When Wi-Fi runs out, you use the cell phone booster. And when you're in range of Wi-Fi again, save your data plan and switch over to just Wi-Fi. That's a great convenience. Here's the antenna for the new Connect 2. This goes on the roof, and therein is my dilemma. My rooftop is totally covered by solar panels. So I'm not sure where I could mount this, although I surely would like to. Maybe it's not going to work out for me, but for many others, this is an ideal solution. Something else WineGuard is doing with this unit, it's selling its own data plans, providing you that cellular access depending on how much data you are going to use every month. The most available is 20 gigs a month, and that costs $150. If you don't want WineGuard's plan, you can swap out your own SIM card from whatever device you're using, a cell phone or a data card, and that way you're going to be accessing your own plan on your existing network. That is pretty slick. So there you go. Powerful ways from three different companies to ensure that you always have a solid internet connection when you're on the road. Now, if you'd like more information about all this, just look in the description below. I will put links to all of these things I just showed you right there. Also, whatever system I'm going to install on my RV, I will do a separate video on that. We'll show you how we install it, and we'll run some tests and comparisons of all the numbers as well. All that's coming up in future videos. Meantime, would you do me a favor and subscribe to the RV Lifestyle channel right here on YouTube. And don't forget to hit that little bell, and then you'll be notified when new videos are online. I'm Mike Wendland. Thanks so much for watching.